Get set. Go.
Here we go. Peter knocks the first one out. Isaiah's got the lead going here. Isaiah's got the hang of this. I can tell. Come on, Tony, let's call this. Peter's got one in already. Isaiah's got his.
It's about equal now.
Ian's got one in.
One each, two more to go.
He's almost got two. Two's done. Go for three.
And you can notice that they're getting a little slower.
He's having a hard time with this time. Whoa. A couple more hits. Down. Whoa. Oh, yeah. Oh, Peter. Peter. Winner.
Wow, you guys.
You didn't fail me. My prediction.
Thanks for participating.
You're
a little harder than
so
it looks,
huh?
So much
tougher
than
it
looks. Thanks for playing, guys.
I want to be a great
contest.
Yes!
Yeah.
You won!
Yeah, beer.
First established in 1977, the Golden Spike Can-Can Dancers are always a crowd favorite.
We've been performing at Golden Spike Days since the second annual Golden Spike Days. I've lost count as to how many times we've been here. One of our members is actually celebrating her 20th anniversary as a Can-Can dancer this year. She's quite an inspiration to all the rest of us, and I'm amazed at how high her kicks are still.
Well, it's a ball hockey kind of drop-in thing for a kid sport to raise money for kids who can't play sports. I hear about these kids that can't afford to play sports, and so I just wanted to put this together to raise money for that.
If you're attending the Golden Spike Festival, you want to make sure you come by the Port Moody Station Museum. With me now is the curator, Jim Miller.
The museum has a new exhibit. It's the Port Moody Yesterday and Tomorrow. And the yesterday is a model that was made by Jim Buckley of Clark Street on July 3rd, 1936, because that was the jubilee of the arrival of the first train, this first CPR passenger train. And then the future, tomorrow, the Vancouver Lego Club have done what they think Port Moody will look like in 2020. The museum's open daily 10 to 5 for the summer. It'll be up till September 15th.
Excellent. And people can just come down here and take a look at it?
Yes, and enjoy it and tell their friends and see what they think.
Excellent. So a great place to take the kids on summer vacation.
Yes. On nice days, we are air conditioned for our artifacts, so come on down. On rainy days, why not come down too? We have a centennial train running this year for Port Moody Centennial. Canadian Pacific Railway has donated a train to us for August the 18th. and it'll be making two trips to Mission. And tickets are $30 a person. For more information, call us at the Port Moody Station Museum, 604-939-1648, or online at info@portmoodymuseum.org. And we do also have information on the train listed on our website, which is portmoodymuseum.org.
Down for me, bro.